Good morning, Avon. I'm Maria Perez.
And I'm Caitlin Davis. Thanks for watching the Oreo Report.
Let's send it right over to our weather center this morning.
Thanks, Maria. Today will be partly cloudy. The high temperature will be up to 50 degrees with a low of 38. We will also see a week of warmer temperatures in the upper 40s and some 50 degree days. But this will bring rain later in the week as we get the liquid side of the winter storm that will bring snow to the Chicago area. And this could also cause the wind concerns for the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade balloons. Tomorrow the rain begins. The high temperature will be 39 with a low of 26. Sunday we will have partly cloudy skies with a high of 44 and a low of 30. And Monday as we return to school we will have partly cloudy skies with a high temperature of 48 and a low of 37. We are looking at even more rain next week. Back to you.
On the lunch menu, we have the hot dog bar, french fries, and baked beans in our home style line. And in the international line, there will be chicken smackers, dinner rolls, and french fries. Over in the grab and go line, there will be the daily items plus Greek turkey salad, turkey and cheese bagels, and hot and spicy chicken sandwiches.
New and concerning information about health effects of vaping. There are now 4 vaping-related deaths in our state alone. Now there's a call for more research to find out just how harmful vaping is. Our Zoe Tramke has been working on this developing story. She has the latest for us now.
In years past, the Oreo Report has told you about the harmful effects of vaping. But recently, there have been reports that vaping causes seizures. We decided to investigate and look at the harmful consequences of vaping and its effect on Avon High School. On Back to School Night, Avon High School hosted a guest speaker to talk about vaping and the dangers of it.
But please know, we are here because we care about your kids. We want to support your kids. We do not want to punish your kids.
They're trying to reach youth, plain and simple. They are trying to reach people 18 years and younger because they want lifelong consumers.
I would say it's sort of a threefold problem. So number one, it's a big problem with youth because youth are anxious and depressed. Not all youth, I shouldn't put any blanket statements out there, but the CDC recently released a study that showed that students age 18 and younger right now in America are one of the most anxious generations in America so far, which means there are a lot of symptoms related to stress, being overstressed, and having negative coping skills. And oftentimes that leads to things like depression and, at worst, even suicide. So vaping devices are designed in such a way, using nicotine to try to relieve that anxiety. But all it does is really just create an addiction as opposed to relieving the anxiety, and the anxiety can actually get worse with the addiction. The second reason is because the companies such as like Juul and Blu and some of the others are really, really good at marketing. So they will produce devices and vape juices that taste like candy or cupcakes or fruits. They taste really nice, they smell really nice as opposed to like natural tobacco products. And they also know what they're doing with the messages they're sharing. So they'll say things like, oh, this is a safe alternative. This is better than smoking because it doesn't hurt you as bad. Or this will help curb your appetite if you're trying to diet. All of this is bullcrap. It's just not true. It's all marketing lies to help get you to convince to buy more of their products. That's all they want is your money.
But there are a lot of negative health effects that those companies won't tell you about the devices, including irritation to the eyes, nose, and throat, raising your blood pressure and heart rate, making you feel stressed out. They can create those addictive chemical pathways and addictive electrical pathways in your brain. If you smoke too much of it, you can actually start getting nauseous and vomiting. And even just this week, the Indiana State Department of Health released a research study about several recent cases in Indiana that illustrated there was a lot of coughing and wheezing. And in one really serious case, a kid's lung collapsed because of overuse of these devices. And the reason why all of those symptoms are so bad is because you're not actually inhaling a water vapor, like the companies tell you, you're inhaling an aerosol. And that aerosol, which is similar to like things like hairspray, bug spray, spray tan, things like that, it contains 10 or more known carcinogens. Carcinogens are cancer-causing chemicals and metals. Okay, so those things are in the vape juices. And we inhale a whole bunch of it all day long, naturally, it's going to cause bad symptoms.
Sometimes they'll even explode while you're using them, especially if you use them all the time. And it can cause some pretty nasty burns to your face and to your ears, and it can burn right through purses and clothing to burn your skin. This happens pretty frequently.
I have heard about the cases of being linked to seizures, and I think a lot of that has to do with the huge amounts of nicotine that it delivers to the brain and bloodstream. So the human brain is not designed for substances like that. It's really stupid. It's also a waste of your money when you could be going on dates or going out and having a hamburger instead or buying the pair of shoes you've been saving up for. Like, just don't do it. Spend your money elsewhere. And also, it's very important to find healthy coping skills, right? Like, we public health folks, we get you're stressed out. We get stressed too. You're stressed, you're dealing with trauma in your relationships or maybe at home, your home life is really hard. Find positive coping skills, whether that's therapy, whether that's medication prescribed to you by a doctor, whether that's finding an activity or hobby that you enjoy that relieves your stress. Those are all way better for you than a vaping device.
In April, the FDA announced it was investigating 32 reports of people suffering seizures after vaping. But since then, 92 more reports were made to the agency. According to AAP data, last year, 20% of high school students used e-cigarettes. That's a 75% jump overall since 2017. But there have also been many cases of it here locally at the high school. We met with Mr. Hines to discuss the consequences and dangers of vaping.
Last year, we had like 54 incidents of tobacco that were caught while they're here at school. We've already had a couple this school year. And what we talk to them about is, number one, is do you understand what you are ingesting into your body? So that's always the first question. Very frequently, students don't know. They don't know that it's an aerosol. They don't know that there's carcinogens inside of it. They don't know that a little pod of a Juul is equivalent to a pack of cigarettes. And so I think in their mind, they may be thinking, hey, it's water vapor or something like that, but that's a myth, that's not true, and they're actually really harming themselves and getting themselves addicted to nicotine, which is not a good habit to have. I will say that on the second offense, there is a ticket involved where you will be fined, and it's a pretty hefty fine for using tobacco products here on campus. We're never going to bring your name up. If you see something, we'd rather have conversations with kids, because the last thing we want is young teenagers getting themselves addicted to nicotine. It's a costly habit. It's clearly a major health concern. And if we can try to help curb that early, we'd much rather do that. So I know that there's a lot of students here that do not want vaping in the school, and we just need those students and those eyes and ears to just let us know so that we can try to address that with those kids to maybe help them before they get addicted.
For AHS News, I'm Zoe Tramke.
And now, it's time for another edition of Magic Monday. What will Dylan amaze us with today?
How's it going, Avon? I'm Dylan Lloyd. This is my mystical segment, Magic Monday. Dream on, dream
on, dream on, dream on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the cards. I will place one. That first card I lay down, that number is the one that we focus on. Okay. So I just laid down first card, 10 of clubs. So that's gonna equal 10. And then I'm just gonna put three more cards there. So 11, 12, 13. King, that's already 13, so we leave it. 10, 11, 12, 13. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, we have a 7 left. We can't get to 13, so I'm just gonna keep that off to the side. And now, since we have these two kings, and those are only one, we'll get rid of those two. Not that it really mattered. Now, Thomas, I want you to go ahead, pick three piles, and just take them out.
83 pile?
Yeah, in fact, we'll do it this way.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so.
Pick
any of these piles and bring them up here and flip them over. Alright, now what we're gonna do is we have this. I'll pick up the rest of these piles. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to count out 10 just to get rid of this stack here. So,
okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Go ahead, pick any top card from these piles here. And flip it over.
Flip it over?
Yep,
right here.
That'll work. You can just flip it and put it right there too. Alright, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Flip over one more card.
From this pile or any of them?
From one pile. An ace will get rid of one. I have three cards. I'm not sure which, but if this trick goes right, that card will be a three. So why don't you go ahead and flip that over?
Okay. Wow. That's crazy. Are you serious? That's insane. How did you do that?
I'm not going to reveal that.
That's crazy. I thought the whole point was supposed to be like your dealer. That's crazy.
All right.
Wow. That's a good trick.
What did you think of the trick?
The trick was pretty great. Honestly, I don't know how you do it.
That's it for your Magic Monday. If you would like to be featured, email me. Until next time, I'm Dylan.
In sports today, the girls' freshman basketball team plays at Bishop Chatard High School. The game starts at 6 p.m. Good luck.
A1 Esports members recently placed second in an IUPUI tournament for League of Legends. Way to go! These team members got $8,000 each in scholarships for IUPUI. If you want to compete in video games with the potential to earn scholarships for other winnings, stop by the Avon Esports Club on Thursday in room B107.
At the next pre-med meeting, you can meet AEHS alumni, cardiologist, and assistant professor Dr. Kyle Frick. This will be the next Monday on December 2nd in the ALC LGI room. He will discuss his experience in cardiovascular disease, interventional cardiology, medical school, and his current career. A big congratulations to the Avon speech team. They placed 8th overall at the Castle this weekend. Out of many other schools who attended, don't forget the next practice will be December 5th at 7 a.m.
Lastly, reminder, today and tomorrow are both 7-period dates with no school Wednesday through Friday.
That's all for this morning.
Have a great day, Avon.